UEFA have ended its legal fight against a European Super League. Does this now pave a way for the birth of the European Super League? Let's discuss that here on the Football Fan Zone. So just a quick refresher on what had happened then. Back in June of this year, 12 founding clubs across Europe had decided to break away from the Champions League and create what is being called the or dubbed the ESL, the European Super League. And due to fan backlash, particularly from those in the English League and the Premier League, clubs like Chelsea, Man United, Arsenal, Liverpool, Spurs had basically prevented them, or they had dropped out of it at least temporarily, and decided that they weren't going to join the Super League. However, Atletico Madrid also joined them, and the three clubs out of the original 12 decided that they weren't going to drop out of the Super League. Are still determined, even now they are still determined to create a European Super League. UEFA, in response to what happened in June, decided to sanction these clubs, and a lot of them made essentially what were payments that they call goodwill payments of around 22 million quid. Not yet being paid, but this was essentially sanctioning by UEFA and saying, no, you're trying to create a competition against us, and because of that, we're going to fine you, we're going to do this, and if you try and do it again, we'll chuck you out of European competitions, etc., etc., etc. Real Madrid, Barcelona, and Juventus decided that actually that would be against competition laws within Europe. Obviously, these clubs are in the European Union and they are bound by certain European competition rules. And a court in Spain agreed and said, yes, UEFA, you cannot create, or you can't tell these clubs not to create a competitive league against yours because you'll be creating a closed competition, which is ironically what UEFA are criticising the European Super League for. They're essentially saying you can't create a European Super League because that's a closed competition, thereby creating a closed competition themselves. So that's essentially what where they're at. They were challenging that through the courts in Europe and have decided today that they would reject it. A statement actually reads from UEFA, a quote, it says, UEFA says it is now, and I quote, as if the proceedings have never opened. And they've declared it a null and void. So, in other words, UEFA have dropped and they've said, you know what, we can't, literally cannot oppose the creation of European Super League. So the question is, and as far as Juventus, Barcelona, and Real Madrid are concerned, is that the European Super League is still on, that they are still members of the European Super League, and they're obviously going to now focus on trying to create the Super League. Now, why were they creating a league in direct competition to the Champions League? Well, quite simple, like anything, money. And the reason why the European Super League would have been very financially lucrative is because it would have had Europe's biggest club competing as founding members, and it would be the same every year. Arsenal would be in it every year, Chelsea would be in it every year, Real Madrid, Barcelona, etc. They didn't have to worry about the competition of their own leagues and qualifying, so they'll be guaranteed in it every year. And of course, if you're an investor and you'll put money into this, you're thinking, cool, every year you're guaranteed those massive games, week in, week out, year in, year out, guaranteed. It makes the competition far more valuable than the current set up within a Champions League, where we're seeing year in, year out, particularly in the Premier League, because the competition is so fierce in the Premier League that not every team, and so there's only four teams in the Premier League that can qualify for the Champions League, but you've got at least six teams that are big enough or bigger than a majority of clubs in Europe. And so you're not guaranteed to have all the biggest sides make the Champions League. The reason the Premier League was so against, and the Premier League were very critical of the European Super League in particular, because by not having but by having essentially what is a closed competition, there were provisions within the Super League, within the framework, that other clubs outside of that Big 12 could qualify, although it's very few and far between, very limited and so on. I think there needs to be more information on and ways in which people could qualify, perhaps an extended league or whatever. But of course, the Premier League gets given, at this moment in time, they get given seven European places. Now, the way in which the system works, UEFA say, right, you've got four Champions League places and three Europa League places. It's up to you to determine who gets those places. And as it stands in the Premier League, the four Champions League places go to the top four. Nice and simple, straightforward. The three remaining Europa League places, one goes to the league, so that is place number, the fifth place team, one to the FA Cup, one to the League Cup, i.e. the winner of the FA Cup and winner of the League Cup. If a team that qualifies wins the FA Cup is already qualified via the league, then that spot for the FA Cup goes to the league, and the same with the League Cup. And that's not what UEFA have decided, that's what the Premier League have decided based on the amount of places they've been given. If you took away the ability to qualify, for example, if you have a Super League and Arsenal, Chelsea, Man United are all guaranteed to be part of it, then all of a sudden there's no European places being given to the Premier League, which means you've got the only competitive places you're playing for is one, the winner, and 18th, 19th and 20th, the relegation places. And that would be it. Everything else would be null and void within the league between second and 17th. And so therefore, obviously, the Premier League are arguing and say, well, that we won't have a competitive Premier League. How can you have a competitive Premier League if a team like West Ham, for example, can have a really good fit season, push into the sort of, you know, third, fourth place spot and not get anything as a result because there's no more European places to provide them because European places are taken up by teams that are guaranteed them. And so I can understand provisions, and that is essentially why the Premier League was against it, and thereby the Premier League clubs, or the other Premier League clubs, and of course the fans, and more importantly the fans. What this will now do is, this will now test, because there's no doubt Juventus, Barcelona and Real Madrid are going to now push on and try to create this Super League. What they have got to try and do is create a format in which the fans are going to be taken aboard. Now, I'm not necessarily against the Super League, and I've got reasons why, but I'm not necessarily against the Super League, but I do have problems in which they formatted and which they sold it. I think they need to create a better format that's easy to qualify, perhaps a larger. I mean, personally, a Super League, I would have two groups of 10. The four from each group will go on to the knockouts, and then I would have more qualifying stages so that you can provide leagues with more places. Because that you at the end, you've got to sell it to the league. If you go to the Premier League and say, you know what, at this moment in time, UEFA give you seven European spots to qualify for European football. We'll give you 10. And that the league will be worth more, is worth far more money. That, you know, it's the way in which you sell these things and so on. And it obviously needs some work, and I think that's what's going to happen. The problem is will the Super League get the amount of money that they were promised by the banks and the down payments that with the investment that was going to come in if the clubs like Arsenal, Chelsea, Man United, Man City, etc., if they are not guaranteed to be in it every year because they have to qualify for their own league, which they have to do in the Champions League at the moment, what makes that Super League more or worth more money? And I can't see how it is. The only thing I can't, if all these clubs have to qualify, then if you're one of the big investment banks that are wanting to invest in this, all of a sudden it's a case of, well, you're just another Champions League then. The whole point of what makes a Super League so financially lucrative is that it's guaranteed Man United, guaranteed Barcelona's, guaranteed Real Madrid's, Atletico Madrid's, Chelsea's, Arsenal's, etc. When you take away the guarantee, the value drops, and then you've just got another Champions League in all but name. You know, perhaps the formats in which competition is played might be different, but still just a Champions League. So how this is going to play out, it certainly means that the European Super League is certainly not dead. And if anything, there's going to be at least some attempt to revive it. Whether or not it can be revived is the question. Now, like I said, I know it comes across as slightly controversial, but hear me out. The reason why I'm prepared to at least listen to proposals of the European Super League is I do think the Champions League and UEFA are somewhat defunct. I do think it's an old system, an old format, or whatever you want to call it, with the Champions League. I do think UEFA have believed for a long time they are lords themselves, that they have monopolised the market because no one's been competitive to them. European Super League becomes a direct competitor, and that's why they don't want it. You know, I wouldn't sit there and and take any notice on what UEFA say whatsoever. They're going to oppose it regardless. If they promised to heal the world of cancer and whatnot, the European Super League, UEFA will still find a reason to try and knock it back and put it down, because it does them no favours whatsoever. What happens to UEFA? If there's a Super League, what happens to UEFA? It will crumble. UEFA would crumble. It would cease to exist within a couple of years, because that's where, because it relies on the money that sponsorship and so on that comes from the big clubs. But if they're not in it, well, all these massive corporate partners of UEFA. If there's a Super League, do you think they're still going to pay UEFA all their money to watch the game teams that are no longer in it? So UEFA don't want the Super League. So just because they come out and they spout certain things doesn't necessarily mean they're right or true. And I think that's, you need to take that into consideration. Reason why I'm against the Super League in the format that it was sold, but I would be open to a better format that increased the potential of the competition. I want to see big teams week in, week out in Europe. What I don't want to see is a close competition where people teams can't get to it. But I'd also like to see more. The world's a smaller place than what it was when these European competitions were formed. The leagues are far more lucrative. Perhaps in the you for example, there'll be teams in the Premier League that will feel that they are bigger and wealthier than teams from other parts of Europe that can. For example, you've got teams like Everton, who were worth, who had turnover, 200, 250 plus million per year, and you've got a team in Azerbaijan that turns over £40 million a year, and there's no contrast between the two sides yet. One's playing Champions League and one's not. And so I get that, and I get that sponsors and fans want to see these big games played week in, week out, and that's what Super League will bring. It just needs to be a fairer, more competitive way, and in my opinion, there needs to be. That you have to have competition domestically, and you have to have places to fight for. If there's no European Super League places in the domestic leagues, then what's the point of the domestic leagues? There's you've got a first place, you've got a relegation place, and that's it. There's nothing in between. You've got essentially 17 clubs in the Premier League that are playing for nothing. So watch your space. It's not done yet. It doesn't necessarily mean this is a comeback for the Super League, but I do think it's on its way there. And I think instead of just shooting it down, let's hear what they've got to say. Let's see if there can be a format that works for all involved, that we can get a much better competitive European League, whether it be the Super League or whatever they want to call it, that can create more chances for teams outside of those big sides. For example, if you've got a league that says, you know what, we'll give you 10 places, and have more qualifying rounds, and teams like Everton and Leicester would be able to qualify, albeit via an earlier qualifying round, just because they finished in the top half of the table. It would create a more competitive domestic league. So let's see what they propose, as long as it's not a small closed league like the original proposals were. Like I said, I think it was just missold the first time around. Let me know what you think in the comments. Are you for a Super League? Is a revival on? Do you not want a Super League? Let me know your thoughts in the comments. If you like the video, don't forget to click the like button. Don't forget to subscribe. Click that notification bell so you get alerted to videos. And I'll see you on the next one. Take care.